tell us a little bit more.
Well, our Bald Eagle Festival is taking off on the 25th of Feb, as you said.
I said March. I'm sorry. It's February. You're absolutely
February,
right.
February, yes. Coming up at the Maritime Heritage Center in Campbell River. A beautiful venue. And we're going to have guest speakers during the day. Lots of kids' events. And Harrison, the mascot for the Fraser Valley Bald Eagle Festival, is flying over to join us. We will have activities and sales of gifts and goodies, and it's just going to be a wonderful event, a photo contest.
Yeah, that's a neat one. Tell people about that. If they've got good wildlife or bird photos, they can do some winning, correct?
Absolutely. Phototech Photosource in Campbell River has offered to sponsor this event, and you can submit your information to them by going into our website, wingtips.org. And you'll find the information there to do it. It's open for children as well as adults. And a lot of fun. We've had some excellent photos. It's all selection is by People's Choice. And it's just a fabulous event. You'll see a lot of mounted birds as well as live birds like Otis.
And isn't he adorable? Bree's going to tweet here in just a second. Well, go ahead, Bill.
What's Otis's history? Why do you have him in your care?
That's a kind of a semi-sad story. Otis was hit by a car, and he has had injured his eye very badly, his right eye. We weren't actually sure if he was actually going to survive from his injuries or not, and whether that eye would be available to look around, and actually it has healed quite nicely. There's still some scarring that you can see, and that's a permanent damage now on his right eye. But Otis will he'll be out there in the all of our events, visiting people. Of course, we ask that no one touch Otis, just because he is a little wild thing and gets kind of scared. But as long as he's on a handler's arm, he's happy to go into classrooms, and he does a lot of events
from
Pinecrest School in Campbell River, Pinecrest Elementary. And they had a blank piece of paper and drew all of these eagles and fish, which is the theme of this year's Eagle Fest. And so they drew lots of different pictures, and it was so much fun to see them. A lot of variety, but in every single one you saw an eagle and a fish, and it was a great theme.
Yeah, so when people are looking at the posters, they'll know that those talented kids were involved in that. And people can check out their website as well, and check out our website, 973theeagle.com. We do have links on there for the photo contest that Mage mentioned with PhotoSource. If you've got good pics of birds or some local wildlife, get those submitted. And you could be the winner by public vote at the Bald Eagle Festival, which goes Saturday, February 25th. I was at your website, wingtips.org, and I was reading a little notice that I thought was interesting because the work you do is so important. It said about your bottles and cans. I've got some recycling that I was going to take back, and I think I'm going to reroute it. Is that something we'd like people to know about as well?
That's great to know that, yes, we definitely are accepting all kinds of ideas from folks to help us with our fundraising, bottles and cans. If you take them to the depot, use the number 135, and that's in Courtney on Putledge Drive.
Yeah.
And Otis is really looking at Bill. Seems to like Bill.
I haven't seen anything quite like that before.
It's a staring